So, I moved to California. I finally moved to California, and I cannot tell you guys how ecstatic, how excited, how motivated, how inspired I am by finally taking this leap and traveling 2,500 miles across the country to California, where my dreams and hopes and aspirations lie. They really lie, but they don't lie, if you catch my drift. I am in California, Los Angeles, California, and this is something that I never thought was going to happen. There's so many emotions and so many things connected to this move that it's like completely emotionally, physically, mentally overwhelming, but it's a good overwhelming. I've been wanting to make this move for so long, for like the past 4 years, but I really couldn't move the way I wanted to because I was in college, and with college you have to be in class in order to pass, or be leaving was not an option. But once I was finished with college, I figured, hey man, you know, I don't have anything else to be in New York for. That's where I came from. Like, I don't have any reason to be in New York. A lot of things were stopping me from actually making this move. Fear was a big, big part of it. There's so many people in the world that don't follow their dreams, that don't take leaps of faith, that don't take chances, that don't take risks out of fear, out of uncertainty, out of the unknown. And I personally was one of those people. It felt so amazing. I was one of those people. I was one of those people who didn't take risks or chances. And I can't be more excited about this move. I literally just made a decision maybe a month before I actually left to come out here. And I was nervous as hell. I had anxiety, I couldn't sleep, because with any change there comes, you know, that pressure of, and that fear of not knowing, that the unknown. And my situation is a little different because I literally came out here with two suitcases, a book bag, $1,800 saved up, and an Airbnb that I booked for 2 months with my roommate. That's it. No job, no nothing. But when you trust your instincts and you trust your gut and you trust your abilities to survive, if there's a will, there's a way. I came out here on Sunday the 14th. By Monday the 15th, I had two jobs locked in. God is good. The universe is amazing. So the financial aspect of it was kind of a big burden because, like I said, I only came out here with $1,800 to my name. That's all I had. And now I have two jobs, and I'm going to be able to be a little comfortable. I'm not comfortable. I came out here with a game plan, and that game plan will be executed to the fullest. But it's just weird because people don't take chances. They don't take risks. They don't do the things that they know they should do out of fear and out of the unknown and out of that uncertainty of where my next meal is going to come from, or where am I going to lay my head, or am I going to get a job? And that's cool to feel that way, but there has to be a point in time where you have to trust God and trust yourself, bet on yourself, and know that if it's something that you really want and your heart is pure and your intention is pure, you can have it. But the first step is always the hardest step. And for me, being out here, it proves that anybody can do it. And that's why, that was one of the main reasons I wanted to come out here. Because I know that I can be a beacon of hope for others who feel like they need to go and travel or move to another city or country, and they just don't want to because they're unsure. They're so comfortable and content. They have security, financial security, emotional security with their family and friends. But it's okay to take chances and leave. I promise you it is. Like, I'm here. This is only my second day here as I'm filming this. And I don't know what's going to happen. I'm pretty sure there's going to be times where I don't know where my next meal is going to come from. I don't know where I'm going to lay my head. Maybe that's never going to happen, actually, because I'm going to find somewhere to lay my head. But it's always tricky. And I just want to say to those who may be feeling the same way that I've been feeling for years before I actually had the courage, the bravery to actually move to the other side of the country from New York. It's, you gotta have faith. If you don't take a chance on your dreams, you're probably gonna be miserable for the rest of your life, and your life is gonna be filled with what ifs. And that's where I didn't want my life to be a what if type of life. I'm out here. If I struggle, I struggle. If I gotta move back home eventually, hey, I'll move back home eventually. But at least I tried, and you guys can try too. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in the universe. Have faith in God, and realize that anything that you want out of this world is already written and is yours. But you have to take the first step. And for me, I was moving across the country. I'm super excited. I miss my family, obviously. It's only my second day here, so it's like kind of weird not having my mom live on the other side of town where it's a 10-minute drive to see her, or my brothers. But, you know, sometimes in life you have to make sacrifices for the things that you want. And my sacrifice was my family for now. My sacrifice was being comfortable. My sacrifice was being familiar with my surroundings. Out here, I don't know anybody. But it's okay. I don't know where I'm going. I'm winging it. And sometimes you have to do that. You have to step outside of your comfort zone. But your boy is in Cali. And I can promise you that I'm going to do my best, my absolute best, to make the best out of this new journey that I'm on. And I'm excited. So for anybody out there, if you're thinking about moving, if you're thinking about doing something that you had hopes of doing but out of fear of or the uncertainty or the unknown, if the fear is staggering you from actually pulling the trigger on a move that you actually wanted to make, let me be the first one to tell you, you can do it. Believe me, if I can do it, you can do it. Bet on yourself. Take a chance on yourself. And have no fears. What's yours is yours, and what God has written, what the universe has written for your life will be. But if your gut is telling you to go, pick up and go. LA. I'm here.